Hello, and welcome to King Edward VI Handsworth School for Girls. My name's Justine, and with the help of my peers, Eliza and Ella, we'll be giving you a special virtual tour around the whole of the site, and hope to give you a further insight into day-to-day life and lessons here at Handsworth. As you may gather, this is a pretty big school with many different rooms. We'll all understand from experience how easy it can be to get lost, but we promise it will get easier, and there will always be people around who are happy to help. We're starting at the front of the school and the main reception on Rose Hill Road. This corridor is mostly used by staff, but here we use a pigeonhole system where important notices can be distributed and collected by form captains. The conference room here is used for meetings and, if you take part in school council, which is a wonderful opportunity to engage with school matters, you may find yourself here. The main office is the place to go to hand in important letters, and the medical room is located within this space for anyone who is feeling unwell. Here we have our first set of classrooms, starting with maths. As a core subject, alongside English, biology, chemistry and physics, maths is studied throughout Key Stage 3 and at GCSE. Lessons at this school are usually very interactive and teachers always encourage us to ask questions. Moving on to English, a personal favourite. Everything you learn in Key Stage 3 will be gradually preparing you for your GCSEs, alongside encouraging lifelong skills and learning habits. GCSE courses begin in Year 9 for Science and Maths, with options being selected at the end of Year 9 and studied throughout Year 10 and 11. In terms of A-levels, they're chosen at the end of Year 11 and are studied across 2 years in Year 12 and Year 13. This is the pupil entrance, where you sign in or out of school with our lovely attendance officer, Mrs. Hancox. The highlight of our site is quite possibly our hall, which was used for assemblies, music concerts, and the hilarious sixth form review, just to name a few events, before the COVID-19 pandemic. Each form usually has the opportunity to create an assembly on a topic that inspires them and present it to the rest of the school. What better place to present to a crowd? Next, we have the art corridor, where students of all abilities are encouraged to be creative. This is an example of a subject that could optionally be taken further at GCSE or even A-level. It's always a very vibrant area and is one of the many places around school where students' work is displayed. Upstairs, we start with technology. After our renovation work, the tech department will be moving, but for now, this is where students learn textiles, resistant materials, aka design and technology, and food tech. The tech department holds many competitions, including crafty house competitions and even the Next Generation Awards, a national competition in which our school has had a finalist each year since starting to participate, and we have even won twice. The top corridor also houses more maths classrooms, as well as the colourful languages department. In Key Stage 3, all pupils study French and German to a good level, and must then choose one or both for GCSE. In terms of A-level, French, German, art, drama and music are all taught collaboratively across our school, King Edward VI Aston School for Boys, King Edward VI Handsworth School for Boys and King Edward VI Handsworth Wood School for Girls. Here we have classrooms available for two of our humanities, geography and history, as well as a politics classroom for A-level studies. This is one of our computer rooms, used not only for computing, but also occasionally by other subjects while conducting research or making presentations in lessons. I'll talk a little more about computer science later on. This is our fabulous drama studio, with end-on raked seating that can be pulled out, as well as a fully functioning lighting system and plenty of props available in the props cupboard hidden just around the corner. In Key Stage 3, drama students develop a range of skills, including teamwork in devising and, importantly, confidence. This is a comfortable and fun setting where students are always encouraged to be creative individuals. In terms of carrying on drama to study at GCSE and A-level, we delve into the more important playwrights and influential pieces of drama. This display features just a few of the theatrical productions our school has held with King Edward VI Aston School for Boys. We usually do a musical, and in previous years includes Guys and Dolls, Hairspray and Pride and Prejudice Rock and Roll, written by our very own drama teacher, Miss Russell. This room usually houses students' lockers, where belongings such as coats, phones and PE bags are normally stored. However, during the coronavirus period, this room is being used as an extra classroom, as you can see. The Beacon is our annual magazine created by a group of Year 12s. Its release is always a highly anticipated and exciting event for the whole school during the summer term. Perhaps the heart of the school is the playroom, which is what we call our common room for Year 7 to 11. This is always a lively room with a community feel at break and lunch times. Each year group will have their own PAL, Pupil Achievement Leader, who, in short, coordinates the year group and form tutors within it. It is their positions to offer help in a range of ways to pupils who have any concerns. Round here, we have two further computer suites. Key Stage 3 computing covers a range of learning, including an introduction to programming using Scratch, databases, and basic knowledge of computer storage. Students tend to really enjoy programming their own video games that they themselves have made. GCSE and A-level really begins to explore the ins and outs of programming. Just to mention, coming back to the playroom, this is one place where students can purchase snacks, drinks and sandwiches before school and at break and lunchtime. We will show you our dining facility shortly. This communal outside area is a really good alternative to the playroom, in good weather of course. Us students call it Teletubby Land or Teletubby Hills. I wonder if you can guess why. This is our church, which is still used by the public outside of school hours. We use this building for music, another department that offers a great number of opportunities, such as the two music concerts held by the department each year, where students get to showcase their hard work to parents in lots of bands, orchestras, choirs, and even as soloists. Although, I must say, I am biased. Upstairs, the church is used for lessons. Students can have individual weekly sessions with peripatetic teachers in these practice rooms. We offer lessons in a host of instruments, from sitar to piano, double bass to saxophone, and many more. The keyboard room is used for timetabled music lessons, where all pupils in Key Stage 3, and in GCSE and A-level, if they so choose, develop compositional skills as well as key performance skills. Here is our very own sick form block, with its own common room, computer space and serving hatch for food at break and lunch. Some sick form lessons, such as economics and psychology, are held upstairs. All A-level students are required to take the EPQ, Extended Project Qualification, in addition to their A-levels. EPQ is an academic research project that can be completed individually, which aids students in their A-level studies and university applications. This is our centenary room, a multi-purpose space, often used as an extra classroom. In a time without COVID-19, this space is usually used for bake sales, as our school is incredibly passionate about supporting charities and the local community. We always raise at least £10,000 a year to support those who are in need. One of the highlights of the school year is Children in Need Week in November, where every student is encouraged to dress up and take part in form-led activities at break and lunchtimes to raise money, as well as buying and selling cakes, of course. At the end of the week is the highly anticipated talent show Miss KE, which is organised by a committee of Year 11s. It's open to anyone to show off their unique talents for a good cause. In the past, we've had dancing, singing, stand-up comedy, and even hula hooping. The library looks slightly different currently, but usually students can work at tables or computers and are free to peruse and borrow books with the help of both librarians and specially selected pupil librarians. There is an extra computer space on the mezzanine level for older years. Our refurbished science block is used by all years. Year 7 to 11 all take biology, chemistry and physics, which also proved to be very popular A-level subjects, with many students going on to completing courses in medicine. Science groups are named after inspirational female scientists, such as CUR meaning Marie Curie and FRK meaning Rosalind Franklin. There are also many science day clubs, such as the popular Dissection Club. In the same building as the dining room is DB5, commonly known as CR5, which is available to sixth form students in independent study periods. In the dining block, the upper level belongs to RS, which is Religious Studies, where students are always encouraged to articulate their thoughts clearly, debate sensibly, and keep an open mind to celebrate the religions and beliefs of others. Downstairs is our main dining room, where students can purchase food at lunchtime. Students can pay for goods with their lanyards or with biometric thumbprints. There is also a teaching space here, which is mainly used by sixth form at the moment. There is plenty of space for pupils to eat, aided by our conservatory, where sixth formers also have an area to study independently in the times where they do not have scheduled lessons. DB7 is another teaching space with improved accessibility. The Learning Hub is a relatively new facility, which was introduced as a safe space to talk for students. Here, our Senko member of staff, Ms. Mirrors Pye, alongside numerous support staff, can offer pupils counselling services and share effective coping strategies. Here at Handsworth, mental health is incredibly important. All students are aware of their support system here at school, which includes wellbeing form captains in each form, form tutors and PALs, to name a few examples. Now, this is really exciting. This is the gym, where a number of PE lessons are conducted. Beginning after October half term in 2020, we will be having a new build, creating a new dining facility, tech rooms, increased teaching space and multi-use sports facilities. There are a plethora of sports courts here, used in PE and in-house competitions such as house netball and basketball. Just to mention, our house names are Parks, Baker, Keller and Cavell, all dedicated to strong women from history. This is the centre of the sports department, with the foyer that displays lots of trophies and awards. The office and the classroom where PE theory lessons are held, up to the level of GCSE if selected. The sports hall is the main area used for PE lessons. In Key Stage 3, you get to participate in sports such as hockey, badminton, tennis and bench ball, to name a few. We're also lucky enough to have a dance studio here, which is used by our competitive dance team DLP, who have won the Birmingham School Games dance competition for 2 consecutive years. Dance is also incorporated into the PE curriculum at Key Stage 3. When the majority of GCSE content is started in Year 10, students choose between completing a Dance Leaders or Sports Leaders qualification, which allows students to stay healthy while developing key leadership skills. All house competitions lead up to our annual Sports Day in summer, which is held here on the huge playing fields. In summer, students can eat lunch here and is also used for sports such as rounders and shot put. And this is it. We've come to the end of our tour. On a personal note, this school has meant a lot to all of us over the years, and we've really enjoyed our time here. We'll miss it when we're gone. But we hope this tour has been quite useful in helping you understand Handsworth more, although we do appreciate it's not quite the same as being here in person. Even so, we really do encourage you to consider King Edward VI Handsworth School for Girls, and we really hope to see you here in September. Thank you.